Hey guys, thanks for checking out this video. In this video, we're already going to kind of jump into it. I'm going to try to put two games into one video here, because neither one really kind of takes too long. But long story short, this was my first win of the new season. I was playing random squads with people, with TD Chains, TTV, Nutty Gaming, and Spur Up. These were really cool guys that I just randomly got put in with, and they're really good at the game. And so they didn't, and two of them didn't even know that I wasn't friends with the other one. They didn't even know I was a random until the very end. I kind of wish I'd been streaming this game, but I wasn't. So, but this was my first win, so I kind of just wanted to put this video up, because nobody watches my videos. It's more or less basically for me. But this was basically my my first win in the new season of Fortnite. I don't have any kills until the end of the game. There's another squad that landed with us. We're at the Slurpy Swamp. And I just missed. There's a guy. There he is. That is not a teammate. I just missed him. I can hear him. I think I get some shots on some guys, but I can't remember. Don't get anybody down, but basically we're in this fight here at the beginning of the game, and then we'll end up fast forwarding basically to get to the end. The guys I played with, I mean, they're really good. They're much better than me. I'm still not very good at this game at all. Like I play and have fun, but I'm not good in the traditional sense. How the frick did I not see that guy or hear that guy? Is that a teammate? Oh, it is a teammate. All right, it's not just not giving me the little thing. Okay, well, that's why I'm not going after him. Yeah, we had another squad that landed somewhere near us. They must have just taken off, though. Anyway, we're going to go ahead and kind of fast forward, because not much really happens until really the end of the game. We take some shots at some guys. Nothing too severe. This is where we're just... this was hilarious because I can't remember who's driving, but yeah, he basically gets us nowhere where we're supposed to be. So we'll fast forward a little bit more. Yeah, so now we're coming up. We're coming in late to the circle, and we get into a fight with some guys over here. And they took off. What was hilarious was... And we'll switch to, I forget which one of my teammates this is. I'm trying to figure out how I can get to him. He picks up a guy that he knocked and carries him, and is carrying him into, and chucks him in. And his whole purpose in doing all of this was he wanted to build a ramp. And then pick the guy up and then throw him off it. And then our teammate coming in said, "No, fam, I'm just going to go ahead and do it myself." Takes him out. So this would have been this guy's teammate. So he's all the way in the back. I don't know if they make it or not. But we end up moving up. Yeah, those guys are coming in behind. So basically, we've only really had one fight at this point. We're moving into sort of the middle of the map. Or not, yeah, I mean, this area is the middle. So you can see where we're trying to get to. And we're going to go ahead and kind of fast forward a little bit more here. So we'll keep it on chains for the moment. He ends up getting a kill. Because we got into another fight with a group right over here. And I was not late to the party, but I ended up getting some shots, but I didn't get anybody down. I'm trying to remember exactly where we got into the fight. By the way, the new map is fantastic. It's fantastic. It is so much fun. It's so much better than the other map. It's more like a PUBG map, which I just like a whole lot more. So... yeah, right here at the bridge, this is where we got into this fight. That whole squad's cutting across or coming over. So we're kind of just watching from the chains, because he gets a good kill here. Because he gets lasered. One of us gets knocked down. I can't remember who, though. heals up. This is not our teammate. This is one of the enemies. So I'm popping up at the bottom down there, and that's where I'm taking my shots. I knocked the guy down, but he just is able to immediately build back up. So I'm still waiting to kind of get a good angle on somebody. So we got another teammate coming around the side. We knocked somebody there. This guy did a good job. I mean, it's basically 4 versus 1. I mean, it is what it is. You know. Chains finally gets him down. So we're in really good shape. We picked up a lot of good stuff off this group. So everybody's set pretty good. Kind of get it back on. This is me. We'll get it back on me here real quick. So I finally am able to get a sniper rifle. Teammate's kind enough to give me some ammo, because I only have like 5 shots at this point. So we're moving up, and we can kind of see where we are to, you know, the next circle. And there's a group over here that we get into a fight with, but there's just really nothing going on. It's a big gap, so there's nothing that we can really kind of do to close that gap. I mean, we're sighting them in. Several of us who've got the sniper rifles, we take shots, but we're going to go ahead and kind of fast forward a little bit more. So now you can see where we're at. And taking shots here. My teammate and I, we're the only two with the sniper rifles at this point. And then all of a sudden we realize, like, oh crap, we got to get up to our other teammates here. So I'm going to go ahead and kind of put it into, oh crap. We'll put it on gameplay. So I'm moving up. You know, it's a whole bunch of chaos at this point, and we'll just kind of show you who's left. There's the 4 of us. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we've got 10 players. You know, so it's 4 versus 6 at this point. I mean, that's in 2, and Nutty just got knocked down. Now this is hilarious. My sole intention in going over here was to pick up Nutty, was to actually go over and to build a wall around him. But, unfortunately, I didn't know, because I hadn't played in a squad yet, I didn't know that the F button is how you pick somebody up, and F is my default for building walls. That's what I set up. So when I go over to build a wall around him so I can heal him, I end up picking him up and I keep chucking him, and this is just... wasn't intentional. You can see what I'm doing, and then all of a sudden, boom. He's gone, and I'm laughing my butt off at this point. And I do it again. It's like, I'm trying to build. Holy crap. And he was laughing so hard. He's like, what are you doing? I'm like, I don't know. It was just really funny. He was a cool guy, because he wasn't, like, super pissed off that I was doing that. I was trying to get him. It was just really funny. Go ahead and kind of move up, and I don't even know how many are left at this point, but I can hear the guys on my left, so I know they're over here, and I know that one of them's down below. Then I can hear one behind me again, taking a shot at my teammate. I wasn't sure if he was friend or foe. So I see this guy, go ahead and I realize where he's at now. I'm like, okay, let's just go over. I realize he's got a trap. I don't want to mess with the trap. So I duck back down. I figure I'll get above him, and then all of a sudden I see this guy. Knocked him. This guy comes back out. Killed him. And at this point, it's now 4 versus 1. So, I mean, it's basically game over at this point. I go ahead and try to just pick up some shields. And I don't even know who gets the final kill. Okay, so we're going to focus on who finally got the last kill. I go back and edit this because I was trying to figure out who actually did get the final kill. But basically, it ends up being 4 versus 1. And we're basically just surrounding this guy. And, you know, at this point, there's just nothing really this guy can do. Like, we know where he's at. I mean, there's just nothing. I'm pretty sure it's for up gets the kill. I think he does. I think he gets the win. Because I killed the last two guys in the other on the other team, so this ends up just being the last guy. Yeah, he's right there on the left. There he goes. Oh, that's a good shot. Yeah, right through there. So, basically, get my my first win of the season. Shout out to these guys. They were the nicest guys. They really were. I mean, they were just calm, cool, and collect, and just like just. They were just the nicest guys, and I really appreciated playing with them just because I was, you know, a random, and, you know, they didn't care that I was random. Mainly because two of them didn't even know I was random. But anyway, let's go ahead and jump into my first solo win of the season. Alrighty, guys, so in this game, you can kind of see down here, you know, I get three kills in the game. Where was the bus? Where was I going to? I'm trying to remember where I was going to because I don't even remember. That's obviously me right there. That's right. I was doing what I normally like to do when I play solo, which is go really far out. I that's just the way that I like to play the game. It's just what I was doing. So I was trying to go to Craggy Cliffs, and when I did that, I kind of doubled back and I saw, and we're going to just speed it up here. I saw that there really wasn't anybody going to Pleasant Park. So, you know, I knew that I saw a couple guys basically land over here. And something actually happens. I haven't watched this replay yet. So I'm going to try to see if I can find out. Because I think there was a bot that was over here. And I don't mean that in a derogatory term. And, like, I literally think that there was a bot over there. Because the fight these two end up having was horrible. And I was trying to... I was trying to clean up the fight. And I end up not being able to see. I'm going to slow it back down. And alright, well, I'm all the way back here. We're going to go back to gameplay. So I'm like looking back and double checking. Because I don't hear that fight going on anymore. I'm like, you know, what kind of happened? So I'm waiting and I'm looking. And we're just going to go super fast here. I'm just trying to get all my mats and get everything that I need. And so I end up moving up. I'm trying to double check, and that's when I realized, like, all this crap's right there. So now I see this guy down here, so that's not who I saw earlier. I take that shot, and I completely miss it right there. Now, this guy knows he just got shot at, but he doesn't know where it came from. So I just move up the hill. I miss my next shot as well, which I don't even know how I missed that shot, but that guy was so far off. I get that guy down right there, whatever his name is, Deathbringer. It was Brock. So I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward here. Try to fish. I go ahead and double back just because the one thing that I'm not crazy about so far in the game, but it's okay, it's not a big ordeal, is there's not a lot of ammo in the game. Like, you've really gotta utilize your ammo. So I had, like, three first aid kits, so, again, you know, I wasn't worried about making the circle. It was fine. I'll slow it back down a little bit. The thing that surprised me is when I made it to the circle here, I mean, there just wasn't anybody here. Now, I saw a guy basically over in that area, then I see a guy over in this area. So I double back. Now, this is kind of a key thing, the way that I play the game, is... I'm not looking to get into a fight, I'm looking to get to the circle. So you can see the distance that I've got. I got a long way to go. So I loot a little bit more, I grab that, I go ahead and heal up to get to full health. I do that in a minute, I think. And then I hear shots outside. Yeah, so I hear the shots over here. I go over, but I don't have a good angle on this guy, and I realize, like, I've got to go. Like, I can't mess with it, because that guy's going to be running as well. So, you know, the circle's going to be coming in any second. Yeah, okay, so quick edit there. So I'm moving up and all of a sudden there's a Joker up here. Now he sees me. I'm trying to I want to get to him, because I have to play a little bit sneaky with what I did to this guy. So he sees me, does a little bit of damage. I know that once I go underneath the mountain, I know he can't see me. So what I'm actually doing at the bottom of the hill there is I know that I can't go up the waterfall. So what I wanted him to think was that I was going to go down the river and then pop out there. But what I'm actually doing, you can't see, is I'm at the bottom and I'm turning the boat around and I'm going right back the way I came. Because I know that's there's no way I'm going to let this guy kill me from above. I know I don't have a choice. I have to go back. I just don't have a choice. So that's why I end up moving back where I was. I try going up the hill as best I can. And I ditch it right here. This game, by the way, is not a really good game for me. It's really not. I end up taking a little bit of damage. When I make the circle here, I end up hearing a bunch of gunfire that's over on my right. So I can hear basically the fight that's taking place right over here between Toxic and Doctor whoever. So there's nobody on my left. Now, I had no intention of going into Lazy Lake. That's just a death trap. Don't get into buildings late in the game unless the circle's ending there. That's my philosophy. So these two guys are going. Now, what I'm focused on at this point is like, okay, I need to make the next circle, but I got to figure out the best place for me to end up. So I keep looking over here because these guys were fighting for a while. So I see a little bit of a whatchamajigget building there. So they're still going at it. So it's like, okay. And so at this point, you know, I had actually pulled up my map and good Lord. And I see this house right here. So there's a part of me that says like, okay, make the house, but don't go in the house. Because if there is somebody that's already there, they're going to be in the house. So you'll at least be able to hear to kind of double check. And secondly, I knew that these guys that were back here, they were going to be coming to this house. Whoever the winner of that fight's going to be, that's where they're going to come. Because they're going to have to make the circle, and it's going to have to be a straight line. So I was just looking at my map. I go to the bottom of the hill. I'm double checking, and I tell myself, like, perfect. Get behind the post. Just sit here, pull out the shotgun, and with whoever this is, it's about to show up, because they're coming. You're going to pop out. You'll get the first shot off. You know, just try to get a headshot on the guy. So I can still hear him back there fighting. So I know that they're probably not going to have time to heal up, whoever the winner is going to end up being. That once they show up, you know, I probably am only going to need two shots and I'll get the guy down. Because he's not going to have time to stop and heal. He just won't. So, we'll kind of look at it from this guy's perspective, so you can kind of see the way that I position myself. So here he is. He's at what? Like, I mean, what would that be? Like 35? So, if you look at it right here, that's not the button I want to hit. So, I'm positioned right behind this pole. So I can see everything. I see this guy coming. I know where he's coming. I'm going to lean right into the shot. Pop straight down. Boom. And so how much damage did I just do? So now he's at about, that'd be about 65 health. He tries to build up, get away, and I turn him to the corner. Boom, second shot. Get him down, get all his stuff. So, you know, it's not like I'm trying to toot my own horn, like I did something that is advanced game theory for Fortnite. No, it's just, check your maps, guys. Check your maps, because you can end up getting kills just based on knowing where someone has to end up being. And I can't believe I didn't get this guy. But whatever. Okay, so slow it back down. Kind of show you the map here. So we're down to five people at this point. Now, what I'm saying to myself is, I see this guy right over here, so I end up doing something that, I won't say I'm notorious for, but just something that I do when I play, which is, I don't take an errant shot, but when not a shot presents itself, take advantage of it. So the guy stops, I was trying to get a headshot, didn't get him, and I'm glad I didn't, because all of a sudden the other guy comes into view, and at first I didn't realize that. If I had realized it, I probably wouldn't have even taken that shot. But, you know, you don't want to take errant shots, but, you know, the guy came to a dead stop. If I get the headshot, he goes down. So I don't get that guy down. The other guy ends up winning the fight. Go ahead, and I kind of move up here, and then I do something. Like I said, so I see this guy right here, and I realize, like, oh my gosh, he does not see me here. So I try to line up and wait for a shot, and then I realize I can't stay where I'm at because he's going to see me. So switch over, we'll kind of look at it from his perspective. So he does not see me sitting right there. So this is easily clapped. He is... I don't even really know what he was looking at, but basically he doesn't see me. He should have. Should have seen the building that I put back there. And... who was that? Rogue? This is the guy that was taking shots at me earlier. So I'm waiting to see if this guy is going to pop back up. But I look at my map, and that's when I realized, like, okay, here's what's going to make a ton of sense for me. I'm not going to come up behind this guy because there's no point, because I know where he's going to end up. He's going to end up right here. So if I can come down the hill and position myself basically right here, if he's not paying attention, I'm going to basically get a shot on him perfectly because he's not going to double back my way. So that's what I end up doing. I'm just kind of waiting. Now it turns out it's not exactly what he ends up doing. He moves in further north, which is not something that I would have done. Based on where the circle was. It just, I wouldn't have done it. But he goes over to the far side. He gets into the fight. And so these guys are basically fighting over there. And I'll slow it back down so it'll be kind of normal. So he went over to go get into that fight. Take some damage here. Rogue, I don't think Rogue wins this. I'm pretty sure. But I don't know. In fact, I'm now curious where the other guy is. Oh yeah, he's all the way on the other side. So, clap goes down, and then right here, zero deny. I don't really know why he was going over to where he was going, but... I hate the burst. But it's now down to us. So I'm watching this whole thing unfold over here. So I've also got a bullpup. The burst fire gun, whatever. I call it a bullpup because this version of the gun is a bullpup. So I see this guy right here, and I'm trying to get a good sniper shot on him. And I realize he has no idea where I'm at. Now, guys, you're about to see the worst build battle in the history of Fortnite, by the way. There's just nothing I can do about it. I'm terrible at building. It is what it is. This guy's not much better. But at the end of the day, I just play tactical. I play with my strategy, and it's what allows me to end up getting wins. It's certainly not being a build battle. So this guy does not know where I'm at. And then he makes not a crucial mistake, but... he does make a mistake here. See, he goes basically down into the valley. Once he's down in the valley, I really wish I'd been able to get my first shot on this guy. So I line him up, and I'm right behind him. So once I give away my position, he immediately builds. I'm not worried about it because I know that I'm close to the circle, but I can't exactly tell if I'm going to be in the circle or not. So we each take shots at one another. Really wish I'd been able to get a shot on him there. And I don't know what his health is at. Okay, so he's at basically 150. I'm at 200. Okay, and he's using a scar. Jeez. I don't know how much ammo he had either. So, I mean, I go ahead and move down. He doesn't even realize that I've moved down at this point. Now he sees that I've built down. And like I said, guys, this is the worst build battle in the history of Fortnite. I'm using the bullpup at this point because I know that I can probably get at least a shot or two on him if I can knock down the wall. And we'll just go back to me. And that's what I'm trying to do. Take a little bit of damage right there. I didn't mean to go out, but I had a fish, so I took my fish. I just prefer the regular AR. Like, I mean, all these shots are missing. I finally do 32 damage. Take a little bit of damage there. He still doesn't know. And so I get back up to 150. And now he gets back up to 100 and... not quite 150. He takes some damage right there. And now he builds up. And guys, I mean, this is... we'll look at it from my perspective. All I'm trying to do at this point is knock him down. That's all I'm trying to do. Is just knock him down. But he ends up building over. I try to knock the walls down at this point, and then I realize, like, okay, he's built all the way over. There's no way to knock him down now. And they're also doing something new with the circle closing, and I like it so much more. So I pop up to the top because I know he's right up here. And I do kind of want to see it. He's trying to heal up. And I do a buttload of damage to him right there. Didn't get that shot on him. I was super pissed. So he just kind of keeps going up and up. I realize, like, okay, I'm going to have to build because now we're not having to go to Timbuktu for the next circle. I set a trap at the bottom, and at this point... I realized, like, okay, this guy's gonna have to come down, so let's just go ahead. Because I still had a med kit at this point, and so I'm thinking, okay, well, I mean, if he comes to the bottom, he comes to the bottom, I'm not worried about it. So I try to build down here, so I kind of make a little bit of a shield for me using my metal. Again, worst build battle of all time. So we're just going to kind of watch it from his perspective. So he knows that I'm down at the bottom. He's trying to knock it out. Every time he knocks one of them down, I just build it right back up. And I know that all I have to do is just to out-survive this guy. I know that's all I need to do because I still had the med kit. So I wasn't worried. So he comes down here to the bottom. I hit him real quick. He takes some damage. He builds up, builds a wall on the other side, blocks me in. I don't think he realized he had me trapped. And then this is where he makes his unfortunate critical mistake. He takes too much damage right there. And I gave him the trumpet. It's kind of mean, but I didn't even get to kill him. The circle did. So that's my first win. Guys, is this a model game? Yes! No, not really. It's a model game. Basically, how to get lucky. But I did a few things in the game that kind of allowed me to get to the end of the game the way that I wanted to get to the end of the game. So it sort of is what it is. I hope this video isn't going to be basically too long. But this is it. This is how I play Fortnite. This is how I have fun. There's nothing glamorous about it. But boy, I'm not really here for the glamour, y'all. I'm here just to get that dub. Woot. So that's number one for solos. So we'll see what happens. Alrighty, guys. So I do appreciate you taking the time if you end up seeing this. I really do appreciate it. But anyway, thanks for watching, and hopefully I can get some more solo wins because this game's just fun. It's everything that PUBG is not anymore to me anyway. It's just fun, having a good time, and maybe someday I'll learn to build. Probably not, though. But anyway, guys, thanks so much for watching. I do appreciate it, and I hope you will come back next time if I put any more of these up. I'll probably put up some Team Rumble ones because I just like doing those as well.